Han skjærer litt via BIFF. Nok skal jeg ta med trip.
Det är det väl löve. Det är så som vi förringar en rivlig wow.
In other countries, will not be allowed to sell meat that contaminated with mercury. So if we don't come with our advices now and saying you should be take care, it will be too late.
Yeah,
okay, it's bad. For sure. You eat all this meat, huh? For the summer, we might have eaten all day. That good for them.
I see our mission in the Faroes. To document the bill we had to pay, that we had to change the culture in order to protect the health of our children.
I spent my whole career walking into the middle of problems. I will get down in the water between a knife and a whale. We will interfere. We will not allow this to happen.
If the anti-whaling activists had not been here, the consumption of the pilot whale would be less than it is today.
Föjen I färgen blev dolka och tom från söder. Det här borde ganska vara barometer till resten av kläden.
Mamma mia!
Angry bird.
Angry bird.
Angry bird. Angry bird. Angry bird. Angry bird. Angry bird. Angry bird.
Yes, very clean, very beautiful. Smart.
The bird is dirty. Chasing the sun is dirty.
Mamma mia.
You come on, everybody! Ready? Go!
लेकिन वो हमारा ये है कि उसको टच करना पड़ता है। मैं बनाना क्वायर में आई मैं भी बहुत थिंग्स सीखी और मेरे मम्मी डैडी भी क्वायर में आना चाहिए और वो भी
सोप्रानो
व्हाट
सोप्रानो
ओके वेरी
आ
आ
आ
गुड
है
एक
आ
मते
आपण जर चांगल्या प्रकारे जर गाणं म्हणत असेल
दिस इज क्वायर
माइंड डोंट हैव अ नाउ कॉल योर पेरेंट्स इम्पॉसिबल somebody not come how do we do this concert
my papa is coming
One time.
हमें चिंता होती है अगर कुछ पेरेंट्स को गाने नहीं आए और किम सर ने उनको चिल्लाए तो वो लोग छोड़े तो
תמיד חלמתי לחזור לאיטליה. כבר שנים שאני רוצה למצוא את המעריי, היחידים שיכולים לעזור לי הם האחים הגדולים שלי, אמנואל ואנדריה.
שש שנים של סבל, אני לא רוצה לזכר. זאת הייתה תקופת נהדרת. היינו ביער, שיחקנו ברובין הוד. לי היה כיף בשואה.
אנחנו בפליריצ'ו. אנחנו מפליריצ'ו, עולים לקונסומה, יורדים לפונטה סיירה, ניקח את הכביש הזה ונרד ככה וככה וככה.
פנטסטי. נמשיך כאן לפטפט, אז נאכל ארוחת צהריים בבית.
מוצרלה, פסטה, סלסה די פומודורו, תמיד עם פצ'ו די פרמיג'אנו, פצ'ו די פקורינו. Bellissimo!
E lo zucchero?
C'è una strada nel vuoto. Chi te la legge, mi chiamo
o mi chiamo? Il suo nome conosco. Yesh dvarim shana ani lo mevi.
Rotfim acharinu, tachana achri tachana.
Andrea!
הם עשויים להגיע הנה כל רגע, ואנחנו חייבים לברוח.
פה, חזרה!
פה אסור היה לצעוק ואסור היה לבכות.
אז עכשיו אני פה פעם ראשונה צועק, כי מרשים לי ומותר לי.
בובי, אני לא יודע למה, אני לא אעשה לעצמי פסיכואנליזה. זה נורא מפריע לי שאתה צועק פה ביער הזה.
טוב, אז אני לא אצעק.
זה יהיה נס אם נמצא את זה.
אנחנו סומכים על ניסים מהממיות.
If you walk at that time, they can get you, they kill you. We used to move at night. We got an old man to help us who is transporting what charcoal into Uganda. Then from there, they registered us as the refugees. Now they took us to Changwara.
Years ago, young girls fled from war.
Refugee situation for the rest of your life.
They believe that a refugee cannot do anything to help anyone in the country.
You're just like nothing, you're nobody.
Sometimes you just get demoralized and say, ah, so what should I do?
Thieves came in the house, catching the knife.
If I got married now, will I go in the garden? Will I have to get baby?
And I'm working hard so that I can be an important person. You continue praying for me.
Always work as you hope, but that doesn't mean you lose hope.
We did the last interview, they gave us the country, and that country is known as America.
people think in America there's no like suffering. Now to see where the earth is ending.
يعني هي صعبة جدا من أن يكون في الإنسان مصاب بمرض وما يقدر يكتشف شنو التشخيص ما مشخص فهذا حرب غير مشخصة حرب أكو أعراضها تبين أعراضها هي قتل ترحيل وتشريد وحمام الدم اللي ينزف يوميا مستمر لكن من تبحث هاي الأعراض من تبحث عن المسببات ما راح تلقاها مختفية بالجسم
طبعاً قبل كنا نسجل نوثق ضحايا الحروب ضحية اللي جاي نوثق نفسنا عن هذا الشيء طبعا
قول للطيارات
وما تقصف علينا سيلرز personally face the great forces of nature. Those forces are not evil or anything. They're just indifferent. You have to live with what comes. It was crash, bam, boom. Water was coming in the boat. It was flooded up above the floorboards, and we knew it was all over. We were doing sailing that most boats couldn't do, or their owners wouldn't do. Most people don't have the confidence to make their own major decisions, so they're afraid to cast off, metaphorically. To lead a life of self-determination. We were willing to take those risks because we had confidence in ourselves and this marvelous boat that we had, which was better than any other boat we ever saw.
I'm in the Antarctic voyage, and I mean, how difficult was that? Lord. I mean, deprivation, really. You know, he was just such a strong character that I think anybody that was in his sphere had to play by those rules or they wouldn't be in his sphere. Griffiths pulled their weight, period.
Deciding to sail to Antarctica, we had to consider the possibility that we might be frozen in. We also considered the possibility that we might die, somebody might die out there.
BBC. London suffered further heavy bombing raids last night.
Welcome to the Ministry of Information Film Division. Mr. Buckley seems to think you're what we need.
We're doing what?
We'll need someone to write the slop.
Slop?
Women's dialogue.
I thought it was a secretarial post.
Well, for God's sake, keep that to yourself.
30 million attend the cinema every week. Your film must show your American sisters that this is a war their husband should be fighting.
So what do you think? No screen credit?
And obviously we can't pay you as much as the chaps.
We must give them a character with whom they can identify.
Uncle Frank.
60s. Looks older.
We all have a part to play and defeat in here.
Not this part. It's a corpse role. He's dead before the end of Act 3.
Just a dash of humour.
And then further
Excuse
along.
Excuse me.
Hello.
Hello.
Oh, certainly.
No, I wrote it.
A lot of men are scared we won't go back into our boxes when this is over.
The work's good. Very good. Between us, we'll have them weeping in the aisles.
It was the worst night of bombing yet.
Miss, I thought you was under it.
I'm sorry, I can't do this anymore.
You and me, given opportunities only because young men are gone. But to turn our back on those opportunities, wouldn't that be giving death dominion over life?
Girls like us, we serve all those people who gave their sons to one war, and now their grandsons to another. If all of this stopped, even if I were dead, I'd miss it. And I'd miss you.
Have you seen it, our film?
I'm awfully good. So are you.
Mrs. Cole, where is she?
Cut!
Could someone please get Mr. Hilliard out of Dunkirk?
סושי או כל מיני עניינים, אה?
לא עשית לנו מניין?
יש אתכם, אני אחזור אתכם לדקות.
בטח.
אם הוא חוזר, אני צנצנת.
הסתובב בי הצנצנת.
האישה משולה לתורה. התורה שוכנת בה מיום היוולדה ככה, בלתי עיר!
הרב הזה, סיפרתי לך עליו? תכירי אותו, תביני, הוא בן אדם טוב.
אתה עוד לא רואה מי הוא?
כל ברכותיו של אדם הם בשערה מכוסה של אשתו.
את לא מבינה שאישה זה כמו ספר תורה?
אני ספר תורה, אז חבל שלא הבאת ארון קודש, הייתי יושבת בפניהם.
מחר מתחילים שבת סחת בית כנסת. הוא התלבש על זה, סידר הכול.
איפה נעלמה הזאת נשים?
אורה?
מרגלית.
תקווה?
נשב פה עד שתהיה עזרת נשים.
ספר תורה קודם לעזרת נשים, מה אני יכול לעשות?
להיכנס בתוך קהילה של אנשים טובים ולזרוע בהם פחד. זה עבודה של רב בישראל. מה יש לכם עם המחלות? הוא את כל העולם סובב. איזה כבוד עושים לו?
יותר מדי כבוד.
והגיע הזמן שנעשה לו קצת בושות.
חייב לכבד את אשתו יותר מעט גופו. זה לא אני אמרתי, זה אמר הרמב״ם. הרמב״ם? מי זה היה תקווה?
Two Jews have been sent to assassinate Hitler.
This is during the war. They've gotten some intelligence as to where Hitler might be.
They're standing outside his home.
They're hiding, they're waiting for Hitler. 8 o'clock comes, go, no Hitler.
An hour goes by, he's not home yet.
Where's Hitler?
Then another 2 hours go by, he's not home yet.
Now it's 8:30. He still doesn't show up. And one Jew turns to the other and says,
gee, I hope nothing happened to him.
Okay.
Okay. I'm the director here. I'm gonna make a decision.
No! Exactly the shit that I'm talking about!
I didn't want to make a film about questions. And I hate all this stuff. Oh, it's not about the answers, it's about the right questions. Blah, blah, blah.
May all beings be happy.
More correct way to think about human happiness is the right kind of relationships.
Most people who avoid commitment are really avoiding conflict.
A man must train his mind like an elephant tamer tames an elephant.
This film started as a graphic design project 6 years ago.
1, 2.
And somehow it all became about me.
I'm just trying to ask the questions that I think you would ask if you were
standing
around.
Oh, crazy. Around. Another person crazy. Me, it's different because I have an immediate experience of me. Trying to chase after something more meaningful turned out to be a big pain in the ass. Of my life working on this thing that says I'm an asshole.
I'm not like other teenagers. I'm autistic. When I'm swimming, I feel normal.
The doctors told us that Michael would never talk, he would never be able to change his own pants, that he would never be self-sufficient. Just accept your son's autistic and move on from there. That's pretty much all we can do. You don't give up. You can't give up on your child.
I like that. Matter of fact, it seems like a very natural transition.
Yeah. Let's see if we can do it.
Music is the one thing that we all understand that we don't understand.
Music has tremendous driving power within the narrative of any film.
Bond. James Bond.
The visual is one thing. When you add music, it becomes something else.
It's a whole different experience.
The score is the heartbeat of the film.
So much of it is felt. It's all about intuition.
You realize this power we wield.
You can make you feel anything we want you to feel.
John Williams made me realize film music can be as great as the classical composers.
Thomas Newman, his music is just so eloquent.
Hans Zimmer revolutionized what we do.
We have to go shake it up. We have to go and reinvent.
For months and months, it really feels like you're going to fail.
Proving yourself is a great force.
There is a chemical high.
Pirates, it's like Led Zeppelin played by an orchestra.
What can the audience really feel?
Doesn't matter how you get there. It's whether it's got substance.
Standing on the podium and hearing it for the first time, I guess it's like seeing your child for the first time being born.
Film music is the symphonic music of today.
How do you make the audience feel like they're coming home?
Your mind is connecting those dots.
Film music has changed fairly radically.
There's sort of a new renaissance going on.
It's so visceral.
It's incredibly powerful.
You can't say enough about how exciting that is.
There aren't too many of us doing this anymore. I mean, you could count them on one hand.
I got a few for you.
Ms. Miller, it's Bruce Weber at the New York Times. We would like to run an obituary about your husband.
I was leaning away from doing it, now I'm leaning toward doing it.
Are you?
Yeah.
It's counterintuitive, ironic even, but obits have next to nothing to do with death, and in fact, absolutely everything to do with the life.
He once told me that he cooked a cat with a priest in Milan. I asked him if he ate it, and he said he did. But I don't know if it's true.
There's certain things you can do, some things you can't do. Morris is trying to push that as far as he can. You're being challenged as far as you will go.
He's purely conceptual. He's just selling you an idea in a pretty raw form. So it's almost a miracle, this idea that you would be able to float a dead Pinocchio in the Guggenheim or nail a woman to the wall. I mean, that's inappropriate. Or have the Pope hit by a meteor or a squirrel commit suicide.
Daddy, Daddy, Maurizio Catalan. We will start this at $1,800,000, $1,900,000.
If you're going to be involved in Rizzio as a collector, as a museum, as a gallerist, you can't be afraid of risk.
Sold.
Be careful what you ask for. If you're going to take Rizzio to the dance, be prepared for a crazy dance.
It looked impossible. It looked preposterous that actually the Guggenheim would do something like this.
This site, good or bad, crapola or transcendence, you'll remember. This changes your idea.
I think he's probably one of the greatest artists that we have today, but he could also be the worst. It's gonna be one or the other. It's not gonna fall in the middle.
These rivers in India are like blood is to the body. And they feed this country on every level.
To me, Ganga is mother. It's not mere water.
Our idea was simple. Follow the river 1,500 miles to see if the Ganges magic is still present.
Executing it was not.
When I was young, I used to bathe in Ganges. I don't swim in this river anymore, so I won't allow my children.
Ganga is suffering from industrial pollution and religious pollution.
But if we worship it, then how can we defile? How can we pollute it?
Time has come. That as people have worshipped the Creator, they should take care of the creation also.
In October of 2007, the house was empty.
The tenant had moved out.
We drove up to it. She says, there's somebody standing in that window. I said, no, that's impossible.
The scene was strange, more like a staged incident. There was a body in the room and two notebooks. She had been writing a journal. To whomever finds my body, please bury me in the New Durham Town Cemetery.
And that's where the story of Linda Bishop ended.
She was enormously independent.
People were attracted to her.
She liked to be involved with people.
She was a wonderful mother. She loved Katie to death.
It's such an odd thing that no one knew there was this person in that house.
It just doesn't make sense to be barely existing.
I thought, okay, this is a suicide. But the more I learned about her, I realized this isn't a suicide at all.
She had quit her job, and we packed stuff up and hit the road.
She met this guy, Steve, when she was waitressing.
She was madly in love with him.
She kept talking about the Chinese mafia being after her.
She wrote us several letters, deep, dark, delusional. I didn't want that in my house.
We don't know if there's foul play involved.
I think they were looking for any sort of lead.
She was, in a sense, a prisoner in this house.
She had her apple orchards in the back. She loved it here.
I just counted 270 apples, 22 days at 12 apples a day. That should be enough.
There is my mother, and there is Linda Bishop. Linda Bishop's who I hate.
She was that close to safety and being assisted. Then why didn't she get help?
That last bit of power and freedom, she wasn't gonna give away.
Dear God, please save me. I'm trying, but I don't know what to do.
Aquí estamos en las dos R's. Ya no hay un ser viviente aquí que viva casi.
Central America is simply too close for us to ignore the danger of government seizing power there with ideological and military ties to the Soviet Union.
The Guatemalan conflict stands out for the one-sidedness of the conflict, basically the Guatemalan military against leftist guerrillas.
Desgraciadamente, el año 1982, nadie sabía el terror. Cuesta recordar ese día.
llevaba una niña. ¿Y a dónde me lleva? Me dice, es que te van a ir a vacunar. Vacunar quiere decir a ejecutarlas.
You better start praying because nobody will save us from this.
We asked him who went into the well, and his response was, todo, everybody went into the well.
One of the things that makes this case stands out is that there's a weak link.
Two boys were taken by the people that were commanding the massacre.
The two children would be the living evidence that a crime occurred in Dos Cerros. And how she found Oscar was an odyssey.
We had no idea that this would eventually lead us to a little town outside of Boston.
Oscar Alfredo, usted no me conoce. Yo tengo conocimiento que usted fue una víctima de una masacre en el parcelamiento denominado Las Dos Cerros.
I don't even know if she owns a pan. But she has one of the most amazing palates that I've ever ran into, ever.
Ella Brennan, what an iconic name, what an iconic woman. I would say that there's no more important female restaurateur ever.
She was always this grand personage who presided over a kitchen that was an incubator of talent.
She has this gift of being able to bring out the best in people.
When Ella started talking to me about Paul Credo, I said, are you crazy? People are not going to eat his food. I mean, this is Cajun food.
She knew nothing about the restaurant business. She came right out of high school.
I was learning the difference between beef, lamb, pork. I don't know what I was doing. I was just learning.
Ella was a celebrity restaurateur before there were celebrity chefs.
As things started evolving, we became really a great team. I could really execute a lot of those visions that she had.
Generally, a person who has made it to where Ella is today also has had a little chip on their shoulder where they had to prove something to somebody.
So many people will have such a life-altering setback, you know, literally the project you've worked on for your whole life, to be fired from by family members, no less.
She knew how to make a business work. For a woman, that was unbelievable, because you have to understand, women back then were not aggressive business women. You know, that was unheard of.
You have to remind yourself that Ella was working in a man's world, because she's so much who she is.
She knows exactly what's going on. You know, it's not just looking through you, she's looking all the way around inside you, everywhere. She knows.
Her life's work has permeated the whole landscape of American cooking, American restaurateuring.
She's like the pizzazz ambassador of New Orleans. I mean, she's just got this pizzazz. There's not another word for it.
I was having this rebellious moment, this feeling of being sick of the digital world, how intrusive it is. I went to my typewriter and wrote down a manifesto. We assert our right to resist the paradigm, to rebel against the information regime, to escape the data stream. We strike a blow for self-reliance, privacy, and coherence.
This is our first type-in. This place hasn't been bumping like this in a while.
We affirm the written word and written thought against multimedia, multitasking, and the meme. We choose the real over representation, the physical over the digital, the self-sufficient over the efficient. The revolution will be typewritten.
Bonjour, monsieur. Je suis Mathieu Capelier. Vous avez essayé de me joindre tout à l'heure. Il s'appelait comment? Il avait des enfants.
Tu vas faire quoi là-bas?
Voir qui c'était. Puis voir mes frères surtout.
Mathieu?
Oui.
Pierre.
Bonjour.
Bon.
Il y a 15 jours, il pêchait sur un lac. Il est tombé du bateau, puis on l'a pas retrouvé.
Mais ils vont enterrer quoi alors si l'on peut retrouver?
Quand même, t'aurais pu me le dire.
Tu aurais été incapable de tenir ta langue, tu le sais très bien.
Hein? Mathieu est le fils de Jean.
Tu vois?
Je viens de l'apprendre.
Moi aussi.
Tes frères, ils savent pas que t'existes, puis leur mère non plus, surtout. Déjà qu'elle vient de perdre son mari, puis eux autres leur père. Tu penses pas qu'ils en ont déjà assez comme ça?
Je veux pas faire d'histoire, moi, je veux juste les voir, c'est tout. Et j'ai 2 jours pour ça.
Le pick-up, là-bas, c'est eux. On est d'accord que tu dis rien, OK? C'est le fils d'un ami, français. Il vient nous aider.
Et votre père, il avait une clinique, c'est ça?
Ouais. Je fais pas le con, hein.
Mon père, il est au fond d'un lac. Et demain, on m'enterre sa casquette.
Ouais. C'est pas encore répertorié, ça.
Sans corps, on va attendre 7 ans à l'ouverture de la succession. Tu vas en profiter, toi aussi, de la moitié.
Je me demande ce que je fous là, à chercher un macabre que je connais pas avec les 2 cinglés, là.
Dégage! Lâche-moi!
Sam!
Qu'est-ce que tu fais là, toi? Tu fais quoi avec elle, s'il te plaît?
Sam! Je te fais tout ce voyage pour ça.
J'aurais aimé ça voir un garçon.
Pour aller à la pêche.